Scientists at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology are developing advanced robotic insects that could transform agriculture.
These type of robot will open up a very new types of use case. For instance, we can think of artificial pollination.
These tiny robotic bugs each weigh less than a paperclip, according to new research published in Science Robotics. And compared to previous models, they can hover for an impressive 1,000 seconds. That's over 16 minutes of continuous flight. Here is Hsuan Kim, co-lead author of the study and a researcher in the Electrical Engineering and Computer Science Department at the MIT.
So since our robot, you know, is like looks like a, like an insect, and then it's very lightweight and small, if you can really precisely control the robot, we might be able to do something on top of flowers or leaves, which really requires very delicate interactions.
Right now, researchers are working hard to improve the robot's flight time, payload capacity, and precision. Their ultimate goal is to be able to land and take off from the center of a flower, just like a real insect.
We want the robot to be able to have like board, battery, and the sensors on board. So to do that, we need much higher payload than now. So what we're currently pushing very hard right now is to optimize the robot design to be able to lift more and more so that we can like afford these potential payloads.
For him, robots like these could be especially beneficial in controlled indoor environments such as vertical farms. Vertical farming is a rapidly growing industry backed by billions of dollars in global investment. It is seen as a solution to the food security challenge posed by climate change and geopolitical tensions.
There are really the cases where we can't rely on honeybees anymore, you know, such as like indoor farming, where we can't really have like honeybee combs in it because of like safety issues or some environmental issues. So in that case, we can start thinking of like using our robot, you know, if it works well for those like indoor farmings.
Long term, the team hopes that these robotic bugs will be able to fly on their own outside the lab. But for now, they remain far from matching the complex capabilities of natural pollinators.